So if we pass through Czech Republic and then go to Warsaw, we'll arrive here in Latvia and then at the border with Russia. The way to go to Moscow is not easy, but by now the decision has been taken. Tomorrow we'll go. We prepare our luggage quickly, and the morning of August the 15th we are ready for the adventure. We leave the yard as on any day, but it is not. We are going to Russia. The first day we ride for 1000 kilometers and we'll sleep in Austria, 100 kilometers from Vienna. A good breakfast the next day and we are ready to go. We realize that we need a navigator. We go to an electronics store in Vienna to buy one, but we soon discover we would need a special adapter for the power supply, which we can find only in a BMW dealership. We would waste valuable time looking for it. Never mind, we will proceed with the maps. Here we are in the Czech Republic and then quickly in Poland. It's a long day of travel because now the roads are bordered by forests, which is very nice, but you cannot lower the level of attention. Here we are back on the highway. Here in Poland, work in progress lasts 4 miles. By now it's already night. It's time to relax in hotel. The next day we'll have an unpleasant surprise, because we find ourselves in wrong direction on the highway. After a minute in which we lose courage, we decide to take advantage of a native's bravery and follow him at full throttle. But the situation is not yet completely resolved. We are still in the wrong way, for the wrong directions of who should direct the traffic during the work in progress. Once again we find cars and trucks that come against us, and once again we take courage and follow the car ahead of us, zigzagging between lanes to recover the correct direction. That is adrenaline, guys! We need a long pause and then a good night's sleep. On the fourth day of the trip, the objective is to pass the Russian border. The sun takes us to the town of Daugavpils in Latvia. Here, because of the work in progress and the incorrect directions, it takes us nearly 3 hours to get back on the right track. Then we can finally get out of the town of Daugavpils and back on the road to reach our goal, Russia. The road conditions are beginning to be heavily battered. The landscape, however, offers interesting views. What a pity we cannot stop a little more. Here we are at the border, or better, a few kilometers before the border. There are dozens and dozens of trucks lined up to get into Russian territory. We'll find out then that also the superbike trucks have spent hours and hours in line before crossing the border. Here people are equipped for eating and sleeping. Truck drivers do not get angry if we overtake them by bike, because they have their dedicated lane, while we have to take the same lane dedicated to cars. We will find a little queue too, and we'll spend 4 hours at the border. Meanwhile, the night comes, and we'll pass time taking pictures. Here we are in the morning with Yuri, our bodyguard, who was sent specially by the organization of the Superbike to escort us to the circuit in Moscow. We can also see here long lines of trucks waiting this time to leave the Russian territory. It's dawning and the fog is still low. The temperature has dropped below 10 degrees. The road is narrow and bumpy. Shortly later, Yuri's Honda stops. He'll call a friend to have it fixed, and the two go away looking for a solution to restart the bike. And here we are, abandoned on the dirt emergency lane of a small road to guard Yuri's bike. But wasn't he supposed to be our bodyguard? Luckily, everything goes the best way. A biker stops and we quickly make friends. Meanwhile, Yuri has solved the problem with the electronics, mounting a battery on the back seat. We are ready, refueling and start again. The road continues to be battered, but it will become a constant of our journey in Russia. Most of the job, meanwhile, is done. We've arrived in Russia, and we're finally going to the circuit. The Superbike awaits us.